astronauts flying into outer space isn't much different than flying a drone, because you've got to be connected to Command Center. Here there's millions of dollars sent up in space, and when you watch footage, it looks like they're independent, that they're running the spacecraft all by themselves, floating here, floating there, pushing a button here, pushing a button there, drinking things, moving around, just like they're in their own home environment, but without manned control. Here on Earth, they would be lost in space. There's no way that a spacecraft can maneuver on its own without ingenious men and women behind the scenes sending signals back and forth, making everything connect. Kind of like the pad. The pad has the brains and lets you see what's going on. The remote controller sends the signal to the drone, and the drone and the remote control connect and talk to each other. Now, if you go on YouTube and you type in DJI Mavic 4 Pro, that's what this is, flyaways, you'll find plenty of footage where the drone just seems to have flown away on its own. But there's usually a reason. It's bad command on the remote controller. It's the person controlling the remote control that messes up. However, there are situations where the remote control is tuned in, it's working together, and it's in sync, and for some unknown reason, the DJI Mavic 4 Pro decides just to fly the coop and go away. So that's about $1,300. It just flies off on its own to crash and burn or to fall into the water. Numerous things happen to it when it flies on its own. It's always dangerous and ends up in disaster. And I saw one footage where the man saw where it landed. He could see on his iPad that it looked like it landed right on the beach. He kept an eye on it, and it was so cool. He got in his car and sped up to where it was. It took him about a half a mile on sand, beach sand, and there, lo and behold, was his drone waiting for him, because he was connected still to the controller. And so the spiritual lesson in that for all of us is to be connected to God. He gives us the freedom and the latitude that we feel like we're on our own. We can come and go as we please, do this and do that, plan parties, purposes, friends, careers, life, interests, hiking, sports. We can plan a lot of our activities, but if we ever think for a moment we're disconnected from the controller, or we live independent of God in the way of our life, we're ending up in a crash. There's no way that we can live our life apart from Christ, the manufacturer who made us, to live dependent on Him. And that's what He wants us to do. He wants us to live in close proximity to Him. In the story that Jesus tells of the prodigal son going away from the father, we know the story. It went from bad to worse. It went so bad he ended up in the pigsty. And there it came to his senses, and he says, I've got to return home. Did you know that these things are so creative that they can fly away, and when they get far from the controller, they know that something's not right. So the drone all by itself will turn around and say, I'm disconnected from the controller, I'm going back home. They've got enough sense to know home is where they belong. And they'll actually, if they have enough battery, they'll fly right to you and land right in front of you where it took off. And that's what God wants. The prodigal son realized, I've got to run back to the Father and be connected with the Father. And God wants us to connect. I know there's a lot of people listening to this, young people especially. You were raised in a Christian home, and it got too much for you. You eventually thought you could just throw it all off. You're tired of Jesus, you're tired of church, you're tired of being around Christians, and you want to do your own thing. Fly as free as you will. But believe me, you cannot do that. You cannot leave your roots, your Christian biblical roots that your parents tried to instill. Albeit, yes, I admit, not perfect, but they gave you the foundations laid from the Bible. And once you depart from that and you go on your own and you start experimenting with sex, drugs, alcohol, wild living, party, being unaccountable, it's leading you to a disaster. Your body, the drone, will crash and burn eventually. And the Lord will allow that for a season to bring you back to your senses like the prodigal son. But if you continue, He will let you drift off like those drones that fly off and never return. And it's a pitiful place to be. You wouldn't want to be there in eternity. Why stand in jeopardy for eternity because you're taking chances on earth that you can have your freedom and fly as you will? Stay close to home. You'll never regret it. May God bless you. In fact, I want to pray for you because I feel touched right now. Father, there are people listening, young people maybe, that are far from home, far from you, far from their parents, far from the way that you've trained them and raised them. And Father, in the name of Jesus, I ask you to touch their heart. And as they're hearing me pray for them right now, that they will repent and turn back before it's too late and cause so many scars upon their own life and a jeopardy to you and to your glory that you have instilled upon them to be successful. You want to be glorified in them. And Father, bring them back before it's too late. I pray this, Father, in the name of Jesus. Amen. I leave you with this word to pause and ponder. Thank you.